Let's do the fourth question now. Fourth question. The question is 5 upon x minus 1 plus 1 upon y minus 2 is equal to 2. 6 upon x minus 1 minus 3 upon y minus 2 is equal to 1. You can see this, both the denominators are same, x minus 1, x minus 1, y minus 2, y minus 2. So let us substitute 1 upon x minus 1 as A and 1 upon y minus 2 as B. Once we get A and B, we can find out x and y easily. So this first equation would become 5A plus 1B is 2, equation number 1. Second equation would become 6a minus 3b is equal to 1, equation number 2. Now, easily the first equation, if you multiply by 3, this would become 3b. So, first equation, I am multiplying by 3, I get 15a plus 3b is equal to 6. I will add it. Because it is plus and minus 3b, this goes. 6a plus 15a is 21a, which is equal to 6 plus 1 is 7. So you are getting a is equal to 7 upon 21. That is nothing but 1 upon 3. So what is a? A is 1 upon x minus 1 is 1 upon 3. So x minus 1 is 3. Thus, x is equal to 3 plus 1, 4. Hope you understood it. A we got. What is A? A is nothing but 1 upon x minus 1. This is A. So, 1 upon x minus 1 is A. A, what is that? 1 upon 3. So, x minus 1 is 3. So, x is equal to 4. Now, this value of A, we can substitute in any one of the equations. I think the second one is easier because it gets cancelled with 6. So, let us substitute the value of A in equation number 2. You can substitute in any one, but seeing the equation, you can decide which is easier. Substituting A in 2. What do we get? 6a. What is a? 1 by 3. 1 by 3 minus 3b equal to 1. This is 2. 2 minus 3b equal to 1. Minus 3b is equal to 1 minus 2, which is minus 1. B is equal to negative 1 upon negative 3, that is 1 upon 3. B is 1 upon, what was B? We have substituted B as 1 upon y minus 2 as 1 upon 3. If y minus 2, 1 upon y minus 2 is 1 upon 3, then y minus 2 is equal to 3, then y would become 3 plus 2, which is 5. Thus we get x and y. You can try 7th question and 8th question. 5th and 6th, if you see, if you divide throughout by xy, it would come to this form and you can substitute it and see it. Divide throughout by xy. I can do that fifth or sixth, any one we will do now so that you can try the other. So let's do the sixth one. Sixth question. sixth question is 6x plus 3y is equal to 6xy. Think I'm dividing throughout by xy. What do I get? 6x upon 6y. I would get 6 upon y plus 3y upon xy would become 3 upon x is equal to 6xy upon 6xy would become 6. This is again in that form. And the second equation you see, 2x plus 4y is equal to 5xy. I'm doing the same procedure here. What would I get? 2x upon xy dividing throughout by xy. What would I get? 2 upon y plus 4 upon x is equal to 5. So now you can give 1 by x as a and 1 by y as b, and you can get a and b, and then you can get x and y. I think after this you can try it. And in the same way, fifth question, if you see, you just cross multiply it, or you can just separate the terms. The question is like this. The question is 7x minus 2y upon xy is equal to 5. So this procedure is done here. You can split it, and 7x upon xy would become 7 upon y minus 2y upon xy would become 2 upon x is equal to 5. So it has become now 1 by x is a, 1 by y is b, and you can substitute them. So please try the remaining sums, and whichever you have difficulty, you can ask as a. Try to complete this exercise. Just 3 or 4 questions are remaining. You can try it.